everyone. My name is Jeff Fields McCormick, and welcome back to the channel. Now, I know that the vast majority of what I upload is Madden Mobile-related content, whether it's guides, gameplay, or something in between. But due to the insanity that is free agency, I've decided that now is the perfect time to drop a couple of videos telling you guys my thoughts on all of the craziness surrounding NFL free agency. I'm going to do two videos today. I'll probably drop one or two more videos tomorrow. And hopefully this afternoon you should see a video discussing my thoughts on Jason Witten going to the Raiders. For now, let's talk about what is arguably the biggest move. Tom Brady is now a member of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now, in all honesty, this is not something that I expected to happen. I figured that if he went anywhere, it would be to the Raiders or possibly the Chargers, since they admitted that they were moving on from Phillip Rivers. It's definitely an interesting move, and he still has a couple of really good targets with Mike Evans and then Godwin as well. So he'll definitely be throwing some amazing passes to Evans. Godwin's going to get a lot of snaps and stuff. I'm expecting Mike Evans to have a Pro Bowl year this year with Tom Brady throwing, because that's more than likely going to be his main target. Tom loves those big physical receivers, so keep that in mind. That's part of why Gronkowski was such a huge part of the Patriots for so long. He's a big physical tight end, a big guy, big player. He was able to make those physical catches, shove off people to keep going. And we know from seeing time and time again, Mike Evans has a very similar skill set. But this is, to say the least, shocking. This truly is the end of an era, seeing Brady move on from Bill Belichick and the New England Patriots. Belichick and Brady were the dynamic duo for so many seasons, more than a decade from when he took over from Drew Bledsoe. There was something special when you got to see Belichick and Brady together. Something about them just clicked. These guys worked together really well. Tom Brady worked really well in Belichick's system. I don't know quite how well he's going to perform outside of that. Moving on to the Buccaneers, which have a different style that they play, ever so slightly, because they do have different skill set and different coaching and whatever else. It's going to be interesting seeing how Brady can shift from the Patriots that have made him and that he has made himself into a new organization with the Buccaneers, into a new gameplay style, new skill sets on the players and everything else. I fully believe that Tom Brady is one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. He's arguably the greatest of all time, but of course, before giving out that title, you do have to put Drew Brees, Peyton Manning, Joe Montana, those kind of players into the argument as well. These guys are icons of their era. He's got a spot in Canton for sure. Same thing with Bill Belichick, arguably the greatest coach of all time. His six rings with Brady is amazing. Brady has led the team for so many years, and it's going to be a bit bizarre to get to see him in the Buccaneers colors as opposed to the red, white, and blue of the Patriots. That being said, I definitely think Brady is going to have success when he's with the Buccaneers. They've got some great powerhouse players in Tampa Bay. Not quite the style and the caliber that he's used to, but if he can take the Buccaneers and make them anything even close to what he did with the Patriots, then we might see a very strong Buccaneers team. Now, do I think that Tom Brady is going to win a Super Bowl with the Buccaneers? No, I don't. The Buccaneers need a lot more help than just quarterback. Now, granted, Jameis Winston with that 30-30 season had a lot of issues and a lot of trouble, and Brady's going to be a huge improvement. He was arguably the best free agent, so picking him up is going to significantly boost that team. I see them getting first, maybe second round in the playoffs, but I don't see them hoisting the Lombardi, even though Brady has taken over the team. Now, do I think the Patriots are going to be able to hoist a Lombardi without Brady? Maybe. Tom Brady was such a huge part of that team that he's going to have a massive hole that a backup is going to have to fill. But I think that if anybody can do that successfully, it's going to be Bill Belichick. When Bledsoe was hurt, he brought in this late-round draft pick, Tom Brady, and built him up, made him into the icon, the Hall of Famer that he is today. He may be trying to do the same thing here. There may be a younger quarterback that he's got his eye on, that he's wanting to train up to be the next Brady. I don't know for sure if that's what's happening. That's just my own speculation. But I don't think that they're going to win a Lombardi right now. They might in a couple of years if he does train up a new quarterback or pick up another free agent maybe next season or later on in this free agency period. We do have to keep in mind that they have one of the best defenses in the NFL right now. Stephon Gilmore had an insane season. They did just lose Kyle Van Noy, though, so they're going to have a hole there they're going to have to fill on defense. I could see them drafting someone to replace Van Noy, or maybe just bringing up somebody off the bench that Belichick thinks has a chance to show out. But Kyle Van Noy leaving them and then turning around and also losing Tom Brady, the leader of that team, is definitely going to hurt the Patriots. But I think that if any coach has the ability to fill those spots with superstars in a hurry, it's going to be Bill Belichick. Like I said, when Blesdoe was injured, he brought up Tom Brady out of nowhere, and he became the superstar that he is today. I would expect nothing less from Bill Belichick when it comes to Brady's replacement and possibly the replacement for Van Noy. So we've got to keep that in mind. He does have the ability to pull a diamond out of the rough and make them absolute legends under his wing. And his coaching expertise has a special element about it. We saw what happened with Brady. I could definitely see another quarterback following in his steps. Maybe not to the degree that we saw, but certainly something similar to Tom Brady's growth under Belichick. All right, so I know this was a bit of a shorter video, but this is just my thoughts on Tom Brady heading to the Buccaneers and what it could mean for both teams. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up down below to let me know. Also, if you're new to the channel and you enjoy what you saw today, please go ahead and subscribe while you're down there. And one final thing, if you would like to join the Locker Room, which is the Discord associated with this channel, I will leave a link in the comments where you can click on that and join the Locker Room. We have giveaways periodically, and with more than 100 fans of the channel, we discuss every aspect of Madden Mobile. So if you'd like to join a huge group of Madden Mobile players, go ahead and join the Locker Room. Let me know down in the comments what you think of Tom Brady joining the Buccaneers. Will he win a Super Bowl in Tampa Bay? Will Belichick be able to fill the hole that Brady leaves? Let me know down below. So thank you all so much for watching. And as always, I will see you in the next Madden Mobile video.